What's going on, everybody? Today we're going to be doing a rear disc brake inspection on this 2007 Yamaha FZ6. I'm going to go over all the torque specs for the caliper, the brackets, the lines, as well as the brake disc thickness and deflection limits, and most importantly, the pad thickness. If you haven't already, please smash the like and subscribe button down below. Really helps me out. Let's get into it. Alright, to get to the pads, to take them out and change them, and also just get a real clear look at them, we have to take the caliper off. To take the caliper off without taking the whole rear wheel off, you have to take off a 12mm here and a 14mm here. The bolts are two different sizes. Before you do that, you'll also want to take out the pad retaining pin, which you use a flathead for. You'll probably want to loosen this before you take out the two bigger bolts here, because it's kind of hard to fight it when it's floating in the air. With the pads off, we can inspect them for their thickness. At a maximum, they should be 6mm thick, as in brand new, and at a minimum, they can be 1mm. And that's measuring from the backing plate right here to the surface of the pad. So we're gonna go ahead and measure this now. Just a hair over 3mm, I'd say. And you should check all sides. Yeah, about 3 and a bit. Check the other one, just to make sure the pad's wearing evenly, because this is a floating caliper. Yeah. And we're good there. So both the pads are good. And while you got the pads out, you also want to check for corrosion for where the pad material meets the backing plate. Check for corrosion around the edges. These pads are pretty old, like they've seen a lot of mileage and a lot of rain, so it's possible to have corrosion get in behind the pad and peel off the pad just from corrosion and bad things happening. But that doesn't usually happen when you buy quality pads, like from the OEM. You also have to make sure your pad plate on the back is here on both sides. That helps the caliper interface with the pads. Otherwise, while you have them out, if you're just gonna put them back in, good time to clean them up and get the groove free of any debris. Next up, we're gonna measure the thickness of the brake rotor in the rear. The minimum it has to be is 4.5 millimeters, and new it should be 5 millimeters. All right, so with my micrometer here that measures 0 to 25 millimeters, 0.01 millimeter precision, gonna dial it in, and oh man. Yikes, I'm right at 4.5, like on the dot. Let's see, let's check somewhere else. We're not gonna check on the outer edge here because that's where the pad doesn't make contact. We're gonna check in this middle patch area where you can see wear and scoring. Here we got 4.54, still really close to the limit. Check up here, yeah, 4.54, yikes. If you measure the outer edge, you get an idea of how thick the rotor was to begin with. And that measures spot on 5mm. So I've already worn away 0.5mm of rotor here over about 60,000 kilometers. So that'll give you an estimate for how long you can expect your rear rotor to wear, depending on your riding style. The last thing you check on a brake rotor is deflection, which is basically movement wobbling out or in towards the wheel. And this deflection cannot exceed 0.0059 inches. Basically just under 6 thousandths of an inch. To measure this, you'd have to get a dial indicator and attach it to something on the bike that's steel that you could lock it into and point the precision tip at the rotor and then spin the rotor over and see if you can measure any deflection going in or out. If it exceeds 6 thousandths of an inch, you have to replace this. It's warped too much. You'd warp a rotor from really hard braking and putting a ton of heat into the rotor. Alright, time to torque things down. This front bolt here, although it's a bigger wrench size and it takes a 14, it's torqued to 16 foot-pounds. And this rear one that uses a 12mm gets torqued to 20 foot-pounds. The manual also recommends you put some lithium soap-based grease on this rear bolt here to help it slide well. This banjo connection up here is torqued to 22 foot-pounds. And the pin up top here that retains the pads that use a 5mm Allen to get to is a 12 foot-pound torque spec. So I've already got my torque wrench set. There we go. Now the 12. Now we're safely torqued there. Just gonna nip this up, make sure it's snug, and then I'll come back with the torque wrench. Fortunately, I have a 5mm Allen head 3/8 drive, so I'm gonna put that in there and torque it up to 12 foot-pounds. There you go. That's a wrap on the rear brake inspection on this 2007 Yamaha FZ6. This job is something you don't want to make a mistake on, so if you don't feel comfortable taking on the job, maybe take it to a shop, or at least do a lot of the research before you get into the job. A torque wrench is a pretty important tool for this job, so it's worth spending the money to have one or borrow one from a friend, ideally. Thanks for watching. Please smash the like and subscribe button down below, and as always, have a good day.